I just want to say thank you for, I was lying down last night, and I was early rising this morning. But I want to say thank you. Father God, you opened our eyes to a brand new day that we never seen before, Father God. And one day we'll never see again. I just want to say thank you. Father, if I had 10,000 tongues, I just couldn't thank you enough, Father God. Because you've been so good to me, Father God. You brought me to my mighty, mighty long ways, Father God. Through hurt, harm, and danger. For that, I want you to say thank you, Father God. Father God, let's have a special blessing on this worship house tonight, Father God. That's open in your name, Father God, for 28 years, Father God. Father God, I know it's been some ups and been some downs, Father God. I know it hasn't always been easy, Father God. I want you to thank you, Father God. But he's the man of God here, Father God. To teach your people, thus saith the word, Father God. I want you to thank you, Father God. And Father God, I want to thank everyone that came out tonight, Father God. And this thing was Robert. They have this preacher. Uplift. It's 28th and 1st, Father God. Father God, I know it's been a long road, Father God. Been some ups, there's been some downs. Been some leaving, there's been some coming, Father God. But Father God, you kept me still here. Father, I want to just thank you, Father God. Father, I want to do a special thank you, Father God, for my pastor, Father God. His first lady, Father God. And Eric Beth in the hole, Father God. Thank you, Father God. He brought us too from a mighty, mighty long ways, Father God. He brought us a God sent man, Father God, all the way from Arkansas, Father God. And we want to thank you for tonight, Father God. Thank you for the membership tonight, Father God. Thank you for all the friends and visitors, Father God. I want you to say thank you, Father God. And Father God, after I said my last prayer, Father God, I hope you give me a seat in the kingdom, Father, from where I just lay around, sit around, Father God, around your throne, Father God. And I give you all the praise for forevermore, Father God. All these blessings at your son in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Just one more time. I say one more time.
Oh, one more time.
Well, Lord, I'm glad to be in the number one more time. I say one more time.
One more time.
I say one more time.
Oh, one more time.
Well, Lord, I'm glad to be in the number one more time. Just to see your face.
Just to see your face.
Well, Lord, I'm glad to be in the number one more time. Just to shake your hand. Well, Lord, I'm glad to be in the number one more time. I say one more time. I pray one more time. Well, Lord, I'm glad to be here one more time.
Amen. Amen. That going out of devotion service this afternoon, we're going to turn the congregation to a pulpit, pull it to the congregation.
Amen. We thank you for lending your voices in our devotion tonight. Amen. Amen. At this time, we're going to have a welcome. Amen. Come forth from Resurrection Temple. Amen. Afterwards, we're going to have, amen, Israel Bethel come up. Amen. And give us a song. Amen. Then we're going to have a church history by Sister Law. Amen. Then we're going to have one more selection. Then we're going to have a praise dance. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Is that all right?
Amen.
Amen. Come on, just give God a hand clap of praise. Amen. I know you done worked all day. I done worked all day ripping and running. Amen. But we finally made it to the house of the Lord. Amen. Y'all just ain't going to talk to me tonight. Amen. I said we made it to the house of the Lord. Amen, somebody. Amen. Through it all, we made it here safely. Amen. Through the ups and the downs. Amen. I don't mind prompting and priming you. Amen. Amen. I don't mind to get you to think about how good God has been to you. Amen. 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 We're going to lift him up on tonight. Amen. As our welcome come forth. Amen. Amen. There my brother go.
How everybody doing this evening?
Yeah.
Everybody blessed?
Yes.
We just want to thank Israel Bethel for just celebrating 28 years with us. Once again, you already know you welcome your family here. And we're going to end this with a song. And the church already knows. So, 1, 2, 3, go.
Resurrection Temple, house of prayer. This is the house, and you're welcome here. Resurrection Temple, house of prayer. This is your house and you're welcome here. You got love, joy, happiness here. You got God, God, God in here. And you're welcome. You're welcome here. And you're welcome. Welcome here.
Amen. 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 We got any guest churches beside Israel Bethel coming up? Amen. 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 If not, we're going to go into, amen, church history by Sister Law, and then we're going to ask Israel Bethel to come up, and then our praise dances. Amen. They looking good back there. I want to see them do their praise dance.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen, everybody. Praise God. I'm going to be saying, reading to you our church's 28 years history. Apostle Lockett is husband of Martha Lockett and father to seven children. He is the youngest child to his mother, Della Mae Lockett, and he is the founder and general of Resurrection Temple House of Prayer. Apostle Lockett has been in ministry for over 30 years, but has been the senior pastor at Resurrection Temple House of Prayer for 28 years, starting on October 10th, 1992. He was called and chosen by God in 1973 to be an apostle and go out and win souls for Christ. And although he started out with a small congregation, he was still determined to press on and was led by the Spirit of God out in the streets. And thus the street ministry started in rough project areas and low-income neighborhoods. Other ministries were developed over time, such as our boot camp ministry, our feeding ministry, our prison ministry, our jail ministry, nursing home ministry, and the Mission of Hope, which is ran every second and fourth Tuesday in the Robles Park area. Among those ministries, you can receive a Breakfast with Jesus and Daily Bread scripture to feed your soul daily. Apostle Lockett is also a participant and a member of Longshoremen Fellowship. And in May 2014, Apostle Lockett fulfilled his dream of going to Africa to preach Jesus Christ and build a strong fellowship with churches there. With other bishops accompanying him, he visited Lagos, Nigeria, Benin City, Nigeria, and Warri, Nigeria. In December 2014, Apostle Lockett was appointed as one of the executive officers of the International Fellowship of Independent Interdenominational Christian Churches and Ministries, whose founder and president is Archbishop Henry Roberts II. And their mission is to proclaim Jesus Christ as Lord of all and unite fellow churches and Christian ministries. In July 2016, Apostle Lockett was vetted into the Archdiocese of the Lord's Holy Apostles and Prophets. Apostle Lockett and Lady Lockett believe that Jesus is Lord in their lives, and they look to God to fulfill the mission of Resurrection Temple House of Prayer, which is to equip to succeed. God has truly blessed this church and all the members with a true man of God who not only teaches, but he lives his life according to the word of God, and it is evident that God is with him. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. To God be the glory. Amen. 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 When you are in Christ, amen, you just don't sit down. Amen. You just starting to do some work. Amen. 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 Sometimes people look at the church as a safe haven. Amen. To rush into the house of God and sit down. Amen, somebody. This is a safe haven. Amen. But there's some work with inside the safe haven. Amen. Amen, somebody. Amen. Amen. You worked out there. Amen. Amen. And you didn't get no reward. Amen. Amen. But when you work in here, there's a crown of glory waiting on you. Amen. 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 Come on. Give Israel Bethel a hand. They're going to come up and they're going to bless us with an A&B selection. Then we're going to turn it over to the praise dancers. Amen. Amen. And then we're going to break the bread of life on tonight. Amen. Amen. To God be the glory. Thank you. God be the glory. Amen. Anybody glad they got another dip? Amen. Amen. If truth be told, some of us, amen, had to dip one more time. Amen. Or two more times or three more times. Amen. 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 I don't know about you, but I'm still dipping. Amen, somebody. Amen. Amen. Before our praise dancers come forth, we're going to ask, amen, that our officers would come, and we want to raise an offering on tonight. Amen. We want to bless the man and woman of God on tonight. Amen. 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 I believe in sowing in good ground. Amen. Amen. When you sow in good ground, amen, you bound to reap. Amen. Amen. To God be the glory. Amen. We're going to give our praise dancers, amen, some time to get themselves together. Amen. They back there juking and shaking. Amen. Amen. They ready to juke and shake some. Amen. Amen. Just like the songwriter said, amen, we went down for another dip. Amen. So I want you to go down in your pocket another dip. Amen. Amen. We want to be a blessing. Amen. On tonight. Amen. Amen. For those who labor in the gospel. Amen. Amen. They're worthy, amen, of a double reward. Amen. 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 All your money, amen, amen, really don't, amen, add up to what we do. Amen. Amen. But we're just showing God how appreciative that we are for the man and woman of God. Amen. 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 I just want, amen, Amen. I just want about 10 folk tonight. Amen. Amen. It could be more than 10, but I want 10 folk tonight. Amen. To sow a seed of $28. Amen. Amen, somebody. Amen. I just need 10 folk to sow a seed of $28. Amen. So that'll be $280 out the way. Amen. If you're able to sow more than that, amen, you do that. But I just want to be, amen, obedient to the Holy Spirit on tonight. Amen. Amen. And I'm not one of them preachers that tell you to sow 28 and I don't put in my 28 first. Y'all just ain't going to talk to me tonight. Amen, somebody. Amen. 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 I know what God will do. Amen. When you honor his word. Amen. Amen. I don't know about you. Amen. But the Bible says, amen, when Elijah was with Elisha, amen, when he got caught up, amen, he said he wanted a what? Double? Y'all ain't going to talk to me tonight? Amen. Y'all might, Deacon Stark, is this mic working? I don't think they can hear me in here tonight. Amen. Amen. The prophet said, I want a double portion. Amen. Amen. Hey, anybody want a double portion? Amen. Amen. So I'm going to be obedient to the word of God and give 28. Amen. But I want a double portion tonight. Amen. So I'm going to give 56. Amen, somebody. Amen. But I do need 10 people. Amen. And I watch how God bless you. Watch how God bless you, because the Bible teaches us that obedience is better than sacrifice. Amen. Amen. And what can we render for all his many benefits? Amen. 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 We're going to ask our officers to come forth. Well, yeah, D, come on up, brother D. Amen. Amen. Come on up, Deacon Starks. Amen. Amen. He said he want a triple blessing. Amen. So, amen. Amen. 3 times 28. Amen. Amen. He wants 74. Amen. They heard the mic then, didn't they? Amen. We want to be a blessing. Amen. To the man of God and the woman of God. Amen. Amen. I believe God going to do abundant. Amen. I ain't got 56. Amen. Here you go, brother D. Amen. 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 Will there be 10 people tonight? Amen. Will there be 10 people tonight? I'm 1. Deacon Starks is 2. Amen. We need 8 more. Amen, somebody. Amen. If you need it, said Pastor, I need it till we leave out of here and go to the ATM. Follow me to the ATM. Just raise your hand. I'll be a blessing to you. Amen. Amen. We want to be a blessing to the man of God on tonight. Amen. Amen. I'm just believing God's word. Amen. I just believe God's word. I just believe God's word. Amen. Amen. I just believe God's word. He's going to bless. Amen. Amen. I just believe God will bless you when you're a blessing to the men and women of God. I just believe that. I don't know about you, but there have been times when I went home and my gas light was on. Amen. But when I got up the next morning, amen, my gas light had moved. Amen. It's like somebody put gas in my car overnight. Y'all ain't gonna talk to me. Amen, somebody. And I know we got all this new technology that tell you 22, 23 miles. Amen. For empty. Amen. And it look like you go 20 miles and it still say 21, 22 miles for empty. Amen, somebody. That's how God works. Won't he do it? Amen. Amen. When you thought you couldn't make it, you made it to A, B, and C. Amen. That's the type of God that we serve. That's the type of God that we serve. Amen. 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 That's the type of God that we serve. Amen. To God be the glory. Amen. Amen. I don't have a whole bunch of money. Really ain't got no money. But I do believe when I put my money in God's hand, he gonna increase it. Amen. Amen. Ain't nobody in here rich. Ain't nobody in here got a whole bunch of money. But I guarantee you when you put it in God's hand, he keeps on blessing us over and over and over again. Won't he do it? Amen. He will do it. Amen. Amen. $357. Amen. Come on, give God a hand clap of praise. Amen. Amen. To God be the glory. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord God, that we were able to give a portion of what you have given unto us. Lord God, we thank you for the obedience, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, for those who gave, and we thank you for those who had a heart to give and just didn't have it. Lord, we ask right now in the name of Jesus that you would increase it right now, multiply it the way that you see. Bless every hand that gave, bless every heart that wanted to give. Bless those, Lord God, that didn't have it to give and wanted to give. Bless them in some fashion that they will be able to give on the next time. Bless this man and woman of God. Bless this house that you have established here on 34th Street, Lord God. We thank you. Lord God, we love you, for we ask these blessings and all blessings. We ask it only in your Son, Jesus the Christ's name, we pray. And the church say, amen. Amen. Come on, give God a hand clap of praise. He's worthy to be praised. Amen. 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 Our praise dancers, they're getting ready. They ready to juke and shake on up here. Amen. We're going to let them juke and shake some tonight. Amen. Amen. Because they're doing it for Jesus. Amen. They doing it for Jesus. Amen. Amen. Come on, give them a hand. They coming on up. Amen. Oh. Hey, y'all, you ready to juke and shake now?
Ain't nobody stopping my shine. They try to break me, try to take me out, but I got Jesus on my side. So bad I thought I would die, but ain't no power stronger than the one that came and laid on his life. And I got more to find, but the enemy can't stop me, cause there's a calling on my life. So when I'm crying, don't let it too long, cause he's the one stepping to make it all right. To lose it again, I'm about to let them know where I'm from. Don't take me there again. Just call on Jesus, my friend. Get me back in line one more time, cause he's always listening. Ain't nobody perfect, everybody's hurting. He just whisper low, save me from my weaknesses. Cause they're always in my time. Come and get your breakthrough, cause I'm gonna get mine.
Dancing for Jesus. Amen. 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 Giving him the praise. Amen. While they're yet still young. Amen. 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 We wish we could move like that. Amen. Can't do that no more. Amen, somebody. Amen. To God be the glory. Give our musicians a hand. Amen. We thank God for First Lady. Amen. We thank God for my son. We thank God for each and every one, Israel Bethel. Amen. We just thank God for this fellowship. Amen. 28 years. Amen. Standing on God's word. Amen. I know it has not always been easy, but God has always provided. Amen. 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 You can tell somebody it ain't always been easy, but God has always provided. Amen. Amen, somebody. Amen. Amen. He is a man of his word. Amen. He cannot lie. Amen, somebody. Amen. Amen. Every day ain't going to be easy. Amen. But every day that God allows us to see, he is still Jehovah Jireh. Amen. Amen. Let us go into prayer. Amen. Heavenly Father, we thank you on tonight. We thank you for allowing us this opportunity to stand before these, your people. Oh, Heavenly Father, we pray in humble submission that you would forgive us of our sins, cleanse us from all the unrighteousness, oh, Heavenly Father. Lord God, for we all have sinned and fallen short of thy glory. And Heavenly Father, right now in the name of Jesus, Lord God, I ask that you would forgive me, oh, Heavenly Father, for my wrongful thoughts and my actions right now. And use me, Lord God, on tonight, Lord God, that your name get the praise, glory, and the honor. Lord God, that we may say something, Lord God, to increase, Lord God, the strength of these your people with encouragement to go on just a little while longer. Lord, we thank you for this man of God and this woman of God that you have stationed here. Lord God, we thank you for the love and the kindness and the hedge of protection that you have kept around them. Oh, Heavenly Father, when folks said they wasn't going to make it, Lord God, they're still standing. And we said, thank you right now. We thank you for all that you've done. Lord God, we thank you for what you're doing right now. And Lord God, we speak into that future right now that greater is yet to come. We thank you right now. Bless their household, Lord God. Bless their health. Lord God, bless their relationship. Bless everything that their hands touch, Lord God. We pray that you do an Obed-Edom in their life, Lord God. Bless them going out and bless them coming in, Lord God. We ask right now, Lord God, that you would touch my voice, touch my ears, touch my eyes. Lord God, use me as you would have. We thank you on tonight. We bless your name. We ask it all in your son, Jesus the Christ's name, we pray. Amen. 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 We do give honor, amen, to Pastor Brunson, First Lady Brunson. Amen. To my brother, amen. We thank God for him. Amen. To the deacons, everyone in their respectful places. Amen. We give honor to my wife on tonight. Amen. Amen. Give it up for First Lady Woodfork. Amen. 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 That's my boo. Amen. Amen. That's my boo. Amen. Amen. We have our ups and downs. Amen. But I love her with all my heart. Amen. Amen. We thank God for Israel Bethel family for pressing their way out on tonight. Amen. We thank God for you. I'm not going to trouble you long. I'm not going to trouble you long, but there is a word from the Lord on tonight. And I pray, amen, I pray, amen, that this word will encourage you, amen, just to run on a little while longer. Amen. Amen. Because we know that we live in times such as these, amen, that we need to be encouraged. Amen. Amen. All of us, amen, at one point of a time, amen, gonna feel like throwing in the towel. If you ain't made it there, amen, tell your neighbor, keep on living, because sooner or later you will. Amen. 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 To God be the glory. Amen. Amen. God is just so good.
Yes, he is.
Amen. Amen. He's just so good, even when we mess up, amen, God is just so good, amen. How many just believe that? How many believe that God is just good all the time?
Amen, amen, amen.
Don't fool me now. Don't fool me. Don't fool me. I heard two or three hands clapping. Amen, amen. We ain't going to trouble you long tonight. We're not going to trouble you long tonight, but there is a word from the Lord. Amen. 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 If you would, If you have your Bibles, when you should have your Bible when you come into the house of the Lord. Amen. Or you should have a device to pull up the Word of God and just don't depend on the preacher reading it for you. Amen. 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 I want to talk to you, amen, tonight out of 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17. Amen. Amen. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17. Amen. Amen. We'll get out your way. Amen. If I push and you pull, we'll be through with you. Amen. Amen. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, starting at verse 17. And it reads as the following. It says, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. Amen. May God add a blessing to the reader, the hearer, but especially the doers of his word. Amen. If I were to take a subject from this 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17, I want to encourage you tonight just simply in Christ. Amen. I want to talk about in Christ. Is that all right? I want to talk about in Christ. Is that all right, Pastor? I want to talk about in Christ because I realized for 28 years on the battlefield, you can't do it on your own. Because my brothers and sisters, we have the human nature, we're designed of human nature that sometimes when we want to give up, the flesh will allow you to give up. Do I have a witness? But when you're in Christ, when the flesh gives up, Christ will kick in. Yes. Oh, I wish I had somebody in here to know about cartoons. I ain't talking about Power Rangers and Thundercats and all that stuff. I'm talking about the old cartoons like Popeye and Tom and Jerry. Y'all ain't gonna talk to me off up in here. When it seemed like Popeye was about to give up, somehow out of nowhere came a can of spinach. Y'all ain't gonna talk to me tonight. Amen. And it seemed like when he was just about to give up that spinach, come out of nowhere, he chewed on the spinach or he sucked the spinach in and he got some strength. Do I have a witness? And I realized, Pastor Lockett, 28 years, there have been some times you've been like Popeye. It seemed like Bluto knock you down and take the girl. Y'all ain't gonna talk to me off up in here. But here it is, the spinach kicks in, which is the Holy Spirit. Do I have a witness in here? And it causes you to go on even if you have to go by yourself. In Christ. What does it mean to be in Christ? I got a few scriptures, jot them down, because I want you to get this thing. I want you to be encouraged. Amen. Paul speaks to the Galileans in chapter 3 of Galatians 26 through 27. He said, for you all, the children of God, by faith in Christ Jesus, for as many of you have been baptized unto Christ, have put on Christ, there is nor Jew nor Greek, there is neither bond nor free, there is neither male nor female, for ye are all one in Christ. Do I have a witness here? Other words, when you're in Christ, there should be no separation. There should be no division. Do I have a witness? That there should be no denomination. Y'all ain't gonna talk to me off up in here. When you're in Christ, there shouldn't be no color. Y'all ain't gonna talk to me off up in here. I'm talking about in Christ tonight. Yes. See, you got a lot of folk that say they in Christ, but the identity that they carry has nothing to do with Christ. Y'all ain't gonna talk to me off up in here. Hey, amen. When you are in Christ, other words, my brothers and sisters, you carry yourself in a way that you want your light to shine no matter where you go. Do I have a witness off up in here? When you in Christ, it does not mean just on Sunday. It just don't mean on Wednesday night. It just don't mean on Pastor Appreciation. When you're in Christ, you take on the identity of Christ. I'm preaching better than y'all reacting tonight. When you're in Christ, you take on the identity of Christ, which causes you to move in such a way where folk will look at you and say, why is she doing that? Why he keep on doing that? Yeah. Why he just don't give up and throw in the towel? Yeah. Because you're taking on the identity of Christ when you're in Christ.
Yes, sir.
Paul speaks to the church. He reminds us of our identity. Since we have placed our faith in Jesus Christ, we should have an identity that represents Jesus himself. Do I have a witness? He said we were baptized into Christ, which means now we have a different identity.
Come on now.
Because I'm in Christ. Don't mean I'm going to lose some weight. Y'all ain't going to talk to me off up in here. Because I'm in Christ, don't mean my bank account going to be overflowing. Because I'm in Christ, don't mean I'm going to have a brand new Cadillac living on the hill. I got to help y'all tonight because sometimes we portray the identity of Christ only to those. If you're blessed, that means that you're in Christ. Because the church is full, you're in Christ. See, we got to walk in the identity of Christ. If it ain't nothing but me and my family, it doesn't stop us from being blessed. Because we're carrying on the identity of Christ, because now we're no longer in ourselves, but now, Deacon Starks, we're in Christ.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Do I have a witness?
Yes, sir.
We got to stop portraying to folk. Because we're in Christ, that means that you're going to have all this worldly stuff. It don't mean that now. Because you got on suits and big hats, y'all ain't going to talk to me in here tonight. Don't make you more in Christ than somebody who ain't got that. Amen, somebody. See, we living in 2019, finna be 2020, and we got to represent the identity of Christ. Do I have a witness? So now, when we have the identity of Christ, that means that we're no longer trying to get folk to see us. When we have the identity of Christ, we're no longer trying to get our point across. When we have the identity of Christ, we're no longer trying to do what we think should be done. Do I have a witness? When we are in Christ, we carry his identity. That means that Christ leads and we follow. Do I have a witness? That means when Christ shows up, he gets the glory and not you and I. Do I have a witness in here? Look at the text. Look at the text. He says, therefore, if any man, I got to tell you that man right there means woman too. Amen. Anybody who say that they in Christ, my brothers and sisters, I feel like preaching tonight. He said he is a new creature. All things are passed away. Behold, all things, watch this now, it says become new. Other words, my brothers and sisters, because I'm in Christ, you may not always see Christ in me. Ooh-wee. Ooh-wee, my brothers and sisters. Just because I'm in Christ, every time you see me, you may not see Christ in me.
Come on.
Uh-oh.
Speak, Lord.
There's some stuff that God is doing in me. Baby, you ain't going to be able to see it till he get through. Oh, I wish I had a witness off up in here. There's some stuff that God is trying to work out of my life, and you won't be able to see it until he gets through with me. That's why, my brothers and sisters, I'll talk to this side. That's why, my brothers and sisters, you have to be careful how you put your mouth on folk. Because when you put your mouth on folk, you don't know they may be in the last stage of getting to where God wants them to be. And when they get to where God wants them to be, they may be the very one that lend a hand to help you up.
Come on.
I'm just talking about in Christ. Christ himself is perfect. Do I have a witness? And he can't overlook sin. Hello, somebody. Because you in Christ don't mean you can do what you want to do.
Come on now.
It got quiet. Because you in Christ don't mean that you can say what you want to say.
Come on now.
Do I have a witness?
Come on,
when you're in Christ, Christ still is a righteous judge.
Yes. Yes.
Do I have a witness?
Yes.
Well, watch this, Pastor Lockett. Christ's last words was, it was finished.
Yes.
Do I have a witness? What was finished?
Okay.
His earthly ministry wasn't finished.
Come on now.
Because he told them, he said, you tear the tabernacle down in 3 days, I'll raise it up.
Yes, sir. Yes.
So he couldn't have been talking about his earthly ministry was finished. Do I have a witness?
Come on now.
Y'all work with me tonight.
Come on now.
When he said it was finished, what he was really saying is there has to be somebody.
Come on now. Come on.
There has to be somebody to go out on yonder's cross.
Yes, sir.
And pay a sin that you and I could not pay.
Uh-huh.
That there had to be somebody to go out and purchase us back unto himself through the price of shedding of the blood.
Yes.
Do I have a witness? Well, now what you talking about? He finished. It was finished. That's when he says it is finished. Because the debt had been paid.
Yes.
Oh, I wish I had a witness off up in here. Anybody ever paid for something and told a last bill up or the last receipt? Y'all ain't gonna talk to me off up in here. Amen. I'm through paying them folk. Amen. Somebody, I know you got pictures on your wall. You framed the last. Y'all ain't gonna talk to me off up in here. I done paid the last note. Y'all ain't gonna talk to me. Amen. When he said it was finished, he took the sin debt that was owed by you and I. Do I have a witness? That's why it's good to know that you're in Christ. That's why it's good to know that you're in Christ. That when you sin, when you fall short, you got an elder brother that said, Lord, help me to be better than what I am. Help me to not make the same old mistakes over and over. Do I have a witness?
Mm.
All of us was guilty. All of us had a rap sheet. Caught in the very act.
Uh-huh.
Do I have a witness?
Yeah.
Ain't nothing you can do just about the day they got you on candid camera.
Come on, come on.
Do I have a witness?
Yeah.
You can't even get in your car, they got you on surveillance.
Yes. Yes.
Do I have a witness?
Yes.
But I got to tell you, there's a surveillance camera off in glory.
Yeah.
Oh, good God Almighty, y'all ain't gonna talk to me off up in here. All of us have sinned and fallen short of God's glory. But thank God for Jesus that I'm in him. Oh, good God Almighty, I wish I had a witness. Other words, my brothers and sisters, we all got the rap sheet. We all been caught on candid camera. Matter of fact, there was a warrant out for all of our arrests. But thank God I'm in Christ. Good God Almighty. Thank God I'm in Christ, because those warrant papers that were served against me, he said, hold on now. I got this one. Aren't you glad that Christ stood on your behalf? Do I have a witness? My brothers and sisters, I just want to encourage you about in Christ. And I looked at this Pastor Lockett. I'm an old country boy from Arkansas. I'm a country boy from Arkansas, and some of y'all may not know what I'm finna say. But mama knew. They would get greens. They would get okra. See, y'all don't know what I'm talking about.
Come on.
They would get apples, peaches. Didn't start, you don't know what I'm talking about. You too young to know that. But mama knew would do what you call, they would pot boil them just for a little while.
Yes, sir.
And my daddy would tell me, he said, Patrick, go down to your granddaddy's house.
Yeah.
See if he got a few mason jars. Y'all don't know what I'm talking about.
Yes, sir.
Y'all don't know what I'm talking about.
Yes, sir.
See, they young. I'm going to talk to them. And them apples and them peaches and the okra and all of that stuff that mom and them would pop boil for a little bit, she'll let it cool off and they'll pour it over in a mason jar.
Yeah.
Come on.
Mm. And they'll put that top on that thing.
Yes, sir.
They'll sit them out on the counter for a while.
Uh-huh.
Then after a while, they'll put them in the cupboard.
Yeah.
Y'all ain't gonna talk to me off up in here.
Yeah.
I didn't know what they were doing, ain't me, but what they were doing was preserving that which they put in. Oh, good God Almighty. I feel like preaching now. And watch this. What mama and grandma and them did, Smuckers and them ain't got nothing on it. Welch's ain't got nothing on it. Come on, somebody. You talking about the best syrups in the land? Y'all don't know what I'm talking about. Amen, somebody. They preserved that which they put in by the mason jar. Do I have a witness? See, when you in Christ, what you talking about, preacher? I'm glad you asked. When you're in Christ, that means that you're in something. And that which you are in is preserving you. Oh, good God Almighty, I feel like preaching. Other words, when you in Christ, you are being preserved while you in Christ. Other words, I got to break it down. They still don't know what I'm talking about. Other words, baby, you don't look like what you've been through. Because you're in Christ and he has preserved you. Oh, good God Almighty. Good God Almighty. Other words, when you're in Christ, you have been preserved by Christ. Mm-hmm. John 15, 6 and 7. He said, "For man abide not in me. He is cast forth as a branch and is withered." Then over in verse 7, he said, "If you abide in me and my word abide in you, ye shall ask what you will, and that shall be done unto you." Other words, when you're in Christ, he gives you authority to ask him for some stuff. But watch this now. He's not going to give it to you until he has preserved you to handle it.
Come on.
Boy, I feel like running in here. He ain't going to give it to you until he has preserved you enough to handle it. I tell your mama them put them preserves in there on Monday. We gotta go in there Tuesday and get them. We gotta go in there Wednesday to get them. Mama would have knocked the you know what out you. You ain't gonna talk to me off up in here. But this time next year. This time next year. Y'all ain't gonna talk to me off up in here. A couple years from now, mama never say, go reach in the cupboard. Y'all ain't gonna talk to me off up in here. Because that which he had put in has been preserved. Ooh, good God Almighty. You talking about some hot biscuit? Oh, y'all ain't gonna help me off up in here. It has been preserved. It has been preserved. So that way when you crack the top, see them old mason jars had a two-piece top. Oh, good God Almighty. Oh, good God Almighty. You know it's been preserved when you hit it. Say, oh, good God Almighty. See, somebody know what preserving is. God has preserved you. That's why you just now getting some stuff God had for you long time ago, huh? Because he had to preserve you to handle it. Do I have? I'm just talking about in Christ. You ought to tell somebody I've been preserved. I'm ready now. See, when you're in Christ, he preserves you. Somebody still don't know what I'm talking about. Somebody still don't know what I'm talking about. Watch this. In Christ doesn't mean you're going to have wealth.
Come on.
When you're in Christ doesn't mean you're going to have fame. See, there's a lot of folk want to accept the calling of preaching and teaching, evangelism, apostolism, and doing all works in Christ. But guess what? When they're not in Christ, they'll soon throw in the towel. When they're in Christ, they'll soon give up and turn their backs on it. Do I have a witness? But when you know you have been preserved by Christ, oh, good God Almighty, they ain't let me preach this Sunday. They didn't let me preach last Sunday. Matter of fact, they didn't even acknowledge me. But guess what? I ain't going to stop studying. I ain't going to stop preparing sermons. Because when I do pop open, I'm going to have some fun. Them y'all ain't going to talk to me off up in here. Oh, I'm going to another church. Pastor Lockett don't never let me preach. Don't never let me sing my song. I'm going somewhere else. But if you read Christ, baby, you learn how to wait up on the Lord. You got a lot of folks talking about they in Christ. But when things don't go their way, you'll find out what they in. You'll find out what they in. They in the world. Do I have a witness? In Christ means for God I live, and for God I'll die. Do I have a witness? All things are passed away. Now I like this because all of us have went to funerals. Do I have a witness? All of us have had loved ones that passed away. Passed away simply means something has died. Do I have a witness? He said all things have died. And he says, behold means to look. All things become new. Do I have a witness off up in here? When you in Christ, baby, I stopped by to tell you the root ain't going to die just today. Oh, good God Almighty. When you in Christ, the root just ain't going to die tomorrow. Hello, somebody. But as long as I stay in Christ, Paul says we die daily. Oh, I wish I had a witness. See, it bothers me about folk being in church all their life and they still doing the same thing. That means you ain't died yet. Church all your life and you still doing the same thing. That means you ain't in Christ. We don't want to hear it, but that's the truth. Because he says when you in me, there's some stuff in your life got to die. He said all things has passed away. There's some things in your life has to die. Pastor Lockett, Pastor Bronson, Minister Woodfork, my brother here, I guarantee you there have been some sermons when you first started preaching. Oh, I feel like preaching. There have been some sermons you wrote and jot down and got subject when you first started preaching. And you go to that same text and that same scripture after you've been preaching for a while. Oh, good God Almighty. You're going to find some more meat off in that thing. You're going to find a little bit more gristle off in that thing. You're going to have a different, more insight about that thing. But if you've been preaching for 28 years and you can go back and pull your first sermon and find the same thing in it, you may not be in Christ. Hello, somebody, because I'm growing and it should be showing. Do I have a witness? Because not only the flesh dies, but the mental capacity begins to die. It's not no longer what you think on the surface. See, when you've been preaching for a while, you learn to look beneath the surface.
Yes, sir.
Come on, come
on. Yes, sir.
Pastor, I told my daughter and my son, I said, y'all pull these weeds out this flower bed. Mm-hmm. Yes, sir. Snap, snap. About 20 minutes, they threw. It's okay. About 3 days later, so y'all go pull them weeds out of there. Uh-huh. Snap, snap, they threw. Uh-huh. I said, what you've been doing is playing on the surface.
Come on, come on, come on.
You got to learn how to get to the root of it. Do I have a witness? You got to learn how to get to the root of it. Amen, somebody. It's no more just John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. See, you just snapping. Y'all ain't going to talk to me off up in here. You got to get to the root of it that he so loved us. Oh, I wish I had a witness off up in here. Love, so love goes beyond regular love. See, when you in Christ, some stuff got to die.
Yes.
Some ways got to die.
Come on.
Some habits got to die.
Yes, sir.
Do I have a witness?
Yes.
There's some stuff in your life that you thought was right.
Come on.
That you thought God was pleased with.
Come on. Come on.
That you thought you did God a favor.
Yes.
But when you start to walk in Christ, you realize you were all jacked up. You were toe up from the flow up. You were beat up from the feet up. You don't believe me? Go to grandma and them house and find some of your old pictures. Go home and go look in your old album. Back then, you thought you had it going on. But when you look at yourself now, look at my hair. Baby, I was a hot mess. But back then, you didn't know that. Do I have a witness? If you look at some of your old pictures, and you thought you had it going on, and you thought you were looking good, right now, I'm gonna let God deal with you on that one. There ought to be some growth.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I know we look at him and say, oh, I was slim and trim. But look what I had on. Look at my hair. When you in Christ, stuff starts to die off. Do I have a witness? And those things that God allows to die off, we serve a God that preserves us. I told you, well, God does not let stuff die off, and he does not replenish. Oh, I feel like preaching that thing right there. God does not let things die off that he does not replenish, because he says over in John, he said, him that bears fruit, amen, after he purges it, he said, will bear more fruit. Purging is a cutting process. Do I have a witness? God has to do something in your life when you're in Christ. Guess what, baby? I don't care what they say about you. I don't care how they look at you. I don't care what they think about you. When you know you're in Christ, guess what? God gonna fight your battles for you. We losing sleep because folk don't like us. We losing sleep because folk defriend us. They still ain't accepted our friend request now. Matter of fact, you delete them because it took them too long. You don't want to be their friend anyhow. When you in Christ, you ain't worried about what folks say and what folk do. Do I have a witness? Watch this. Acts 17 and 28, it says, for in him we live and move and have our being. Other words, when we're in Christ, we move according to what he says,
yes,
and not what
yes,
we think.
Thank you.
Do I have a witness? Everybody ain't gonna agree with apostle. Why he call himself an apostle? If he an apostle, that makes me an apostle. Y'all ain't gonna talk to me off up in here. But if you in Christ, and God elevates you into that apostleship, guess what, somebody? You better keep your mouth off of him.
All right. Come on now.
Y'all ain't gonna talk to me off up in here. You done heard it over these last 28 years. He pastor, he preaching. If he can preach, I can preach. If he can pass, I can pass. You heard folks say that. But when you're in Christ, that which he calls you, he preserves you in that. Does not mean you're going to be perfect in your walk. Does not mean you're going to be perfect in your talk. But God is preserving you to be something that he wants you to be. Oh, I wish I had some preachers off in here that realize everybody can't be a T.D. Jakes. Everybody can't be no Joel Osteen. Y'all ain't gonna talk to me off up in here. God has that for them. God wants you to be what he wants you to be. And if you work with what God, y'all ain't gonna help me off up in here. You got to work that which God has put you in. I'm just talking about in Christ. Just talking about in Christ. Matthew 6, 19 through 21. Listen to this. Lay not up yourselves treasures up on earth where moth and rust do corrupt and thieves break through and steal. But he says, lay up yourselves treasures in heaven where neither moth nor rust do corrupt. Thieves do not break through nor steal. Other words, he says, when you're in him, he's going to meet every one of your needs.
Yes.
When you're in Christ, he gonna provide everything that you need.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
Yes,
thank you, Lord.
You know, a pastor does not have to be over a church.
Come on.
Uh-oh, it got quiet off in here.
Come on.
It got quiet off up in here. A pastor feeds God's sheep.
Come on.
Now, what we mess up, we want to call ourselves pastors. We ain't got no church, and we ain't feed no sheep.
Come on.
There's folk in the jail ministry calling them pastors.
Uh-huh.
Am I right about it?
Yes, sir.
There's folk on the street. Y'all heard the church history?
Yes, sir.
Amen. Matter of fact, I was looking at you the other day on Facebook, and it was some white lady. She was saying she was having some sickness. He stopped right there and prayed for her. Probably ain't never been in the church, but I guess what? She going to say that's my pastor.
Yes. Yes.
See, you got to feed God's people.
Yes.
I'm talking about in Christ, the identity of Christ. Christ didn't have no building. But he was a preacher of all preachers.
Yes, sir.
Do I have a witness?
Yes, sir.
He had a traveling ministry.
Come on now.
See, we love the titles, but we don't want to do no work.
Come on.
When you in Christ, you can't help but get your hands dirty.
Come on.
When you in Christ, you can't help but volunteer.
Yes.
Do I have a witness? I'm almost through with you.
Yes.
I'm almost through with you. I believe if you're in Christ, there ought to be a change in your life. Do I have a witness? There ought to be a difference that you make in those who are around you. Do I have a witness? If you're in Christ, you ought to have a reflection and identity of Christ that those who are around you, they're going to either cleave to you or draw away from you. Do I have a witness? And I got to be real with you. There's going to be a lot of folk that push away from you,
uh-huh,
that cleave to you.
Yeah.
Don't second guess yourself and say, am I doing the right thing? Because some folk don't want to hear it. Men love darkness rather than light. Do I have a witness? There's some folk just ain't going to do right. Do I have a witness? You got to know that you're in Christ. Apostle Lockett, Resurrection Temple, whatever you do, make sure you're in Christ when you do it.
Yeah.
Make sure that all your work, make sure all of your service is what God has told you to do and not what you had a desire to do. Doesn't make us perfect. When I first started pastoring, I sit under a pastor I never pastored before. So when I first started pastoring, I made a bunch of mistakes.
Mm-hmm.
And some mistakes, I questioned myself. Said, God, is this really what I'm supposed to be doing?
Mm-hmm.
If you live long enough, if you have a heart for God, there's going to be some times in your life where it seems as though what God has told you to do is the wrong thing.
Yes, sir.
But God has a way of showing you through somebody that you're on the right path. God has a way of showing you through somebody life that you have changed. And all it takes is just that one somebody.
Right.
Pastor Franklin used to always say, he said, if I could help one somebody, then my life is not in vain.
Amen.
God has a way of showing you, watch this, because he has tailor-made us. He knows what gets our attention. What gets your attention may not get my attention. But God has a way of showing you what gets your attention that you're doing the right thing. If I was y'all, I wouldn't go to that church. I wouldn't be part of that ministry. But if God told you to be part of it,
come on now. Come on.
You better keep on paying your tithes. Better show up every Wednesday night Bible study.
Come on.
You better be in church on Sunday morning. Because guess what? If you don't, it's going to be repercussions on you. Because you're not what God wanted you to be at. Do I have a witness? If you're what God wants you to be at, guess what? The blessing's going to flow your way. I don't care what they say about you. I don't care what they throw at you. Do I have a witness? See, you got a lot of folk. Now watch this, and I'm almost through. You got a lot of folk that want to be in Christ because you in Christ. They see how God has made a difference in your life. And they say, I want to be in Christ because God made a difference in his life. I need him to make a difference in my life. And that's good. But when you get folk that want the same as you got, that's a problem. Because they laying their treasures up in something else. See, you got a lot of folk that want what they get. But guess what? First Lady, we don't want what Pastor Lockett and First Lady Lockett got. We want what God got for us. Because what Pastor Lockett and them got, baby, we can't handle it yet. They've been doing it for 28, 30 some years. I've been doing it for 14, 15 years. I can't handle the load that he got. Come on, somebody. Do I have a witness? Stop wanting what other folk got if you claim to be in Christ. If you in Christ, you should have a desire to have what Christ has for you. Do I have a witness? I just wanted to encourage you tonight to know that you got to stay in Christ. You can't let nothing deter you. You can't let nothing change your heart. You got to stay in it. And for 28 years, from establishing, I done heard some of your testimonies, some of the stuff you've been through. That's just something you told me. He didn't tell me the depths of it. See, we can't tell everybody the depths of it, because we'll look at them crazy. They can't handle it. Do I have a witness? But what God brought you through, it was to help you get to where you are right now. What God has done for you was to keep pushing you and preaching and teaching his word. That's what God allowed you to do. And guess what? He not through with you yet. He not through with you yet. He got some more for you to do. God has preserved you to do the work that he had set before you. If the stuff we did in the world didn't kill us, if it didn't take us out, carrying the gospel sure ain't gonna kill us. Preaching the word sure ain't gonna cripple us. Do I have a witness? Be blessed tonight. Know that you're in Christ. Don't let nobody deter you from knowing that you're in Christ. Amen? Amen. Amen. Come on, just give God a hand clap of praise. Just be encouraged tonight. We want to extend the invitation. We want to extend the invitation tonight. There may be somebody who don't know Jesus Christ in the part of their sins. We want you to come.
Come on up if you
we want you to come. And it's not to be part of a building. It's